Hello students, so again as per our promise we are back with the detailed solutions. Fine, so here we will try to provide detailed solutions. Fine, and for that let me erase this portion so that I can use this for the solutions. What I'll do, I'll not provide in-depth solutions of all questions, but few in-depth, and then simple questions, maybe one or two steps. Accordingly, we will try to quickly move for the detailed solution of all the three subjects. Fine. So, be the part of this live solution of these questions. We just prepared. So, we tried our best to maintain them 100% error free. Fine. But we are also humans, so I hope you appreciate that effort up to some extent. So let's try to start with this one, and then one by one I'll keep on changing the slides, and then accordingly we will start proceeding for the solutions. Fine. So now it's going to be I need this particular slides to keep on changing. Fine. And over there, just slides. So basically these are the things that is code C we are discussing. Fine. And it is a live session, so I hope you will also enjoy the way all these videos are prepared, so that is also going to visible all of you. Fine. So let's start one by one this discussion. That is your first question, and it is for the section C. Fine. That is code C of that particular physics paper. Fine. I mean this JEE Main's physics set, that is C. So in C, physics was at last. That's why starting question is 61. In this particular question, I hope the question is visible to all of you. Also, you have read these questions. The formula basically used is d sine theta is equal to n lambda, where n is equal to 1 and lambda is equal to d by 2. So by putting these values in this particular formula, I'm not going to discuss it in depth. Fine. And simply after using that concept of Young's fringe width, that is equal to b is equal to beta is equal to lambda d by d. When you put the values and solve this particular question, you will get 25, that is fourth, 25 micrometer is the correct answer. That is the distance between the centers of each slit. Fine. So this question, you can say, was not a difficult, slightly difficult from the you can say calculation point of view. So we from our side put this question in the category of moderate to difficult. Fine. Over here they basically combine two concepts. One is diffraction, another is Young's fringes formation. Fine. So this is from the wave optics, and we consider this question moderate to difficult level. Fine. After this, obviously we have to move ahead. So students, it's going to be code C, question number physics 62. Now in this question, the approach is simple. Over here, electron from various excited states of hydrogen atom emit radiations to come to the ground state. So accordingly, the wavelength is provided, de Broglie wavelength. Fine. Nth state and ground state, n is nth state, g is ground state. And you have to find a relation between these wavelengths and with using these A and B constant. This question was, we would like to put this question in the category of moderate. Fine. Not easy, but moderate type of questions. And the solution that has been applicable over here is the basic formula that if I would like to make a reference of this, then you may have learned this formula, this type of result using your wave optics and ray optics combination when we studied the refractive index mu variation. So that was A plus B upon lambda square, so on like that. Fine. So this question was based from that result. So again, 4 is the correct option. That is An is equal to A plus B upon lambda square. So as such, this question was not any, you can say, very innovative in the approach. Fine. This is the basic question, fundamental question. 3V, the thing that is not given over here, it is mentioned. This was the catch point for this question. Silicon, silicon means your potential barrier is going to be 0.7 volt. So it is because silicon, so potential barrier is going to be 0.7 volt. So effective voltage is going to be how much? 3 minus 0.7. Fine. And then you have to find the reading of ammeter. Reading of ammeter means what? What is the amount of current flowing? So very fundamental, very basic question, this one. Fine. So as such, this question was obviously from the semiconductors, from the diodes, but this was a very simple question. And the correct answer, as usually, it's going to be 11.5 milliampere, that we also explained you while I was explaining the keys of the correct keys of this question. So we discussed set A, set B, set C, set D, all four are now online also, so you can compare. These are the detailed solution. Very shortly, you will find the detailed analysis and solution online. So here I am just giving you a quick explanation. After that, if you wish to check again your steps, you can go to our website. Their details are present. Fine. Now let's this particular question. This question was based upon the error analysis, class 11th initial topic. So very fundamental question, very basic question. And accordingly, I hope you all are able to prepare and apply this particular formula over here. So the correct answer is going to be 4.5% as we discussed. So as such, I'm not going to provide you the detailed solution of this at least error analysis question. Fine. These type of questions, you can say CBSE, I mean the conducting body of this JEE Main exam, they maintain their approach of preparing the paper in a very balanced manner. Some questions easy, then almost moderate and few difficult questions. So any student who prepared well with his or her textbooks will definitely find these questions simple and enjoyable. And accordingly, if we are moving ahead, then this question, students, I'm sure you must have solved many times. Fine. Over here, this one, that is motion of a charged particle in magnetic field. So basic formula used is R is equal to MV upon EV, EV or QV. Accordingly, you can write the formula for the kinetic energy, because here V will give you ERV by M. Fine. Sorry, it is going to be capital V, potential. Then use kinetic energy. Let me write down over here. Kinetic energy is equal to half mv square. Put the values, solve it. Accordingly, you have to put the different values of radius of electron, radius of proton, radius of alpha particle. So this question, at least from our side, we not expecting such a simple question based upon direct formula. Fine. So these questions, obviously, in today's examination, I'm sure you must felt a lot happy just by watching these type of questions. So these were very good questions to make your morale high. Fine. So that's where you can say it's a beautiful question paper with the combination of some difficult, some easy and moderate questions. Now, students, in the same way. Now, this question was basically, as I explained during the analysis just one and a half hours back, I mentioned that class 12th, this question was based upon potential and surface charge density. So all these terms, I'm sure you are aware over here, those are mentioned. Fine. And the basic formulae used in this particular question. So let me quickly draw a diagram over here. That is one concentric metallic shell A, then your B, and then your C. Fine. So this is like A as given, B, and then C. And what is the surface charge? Minus, and then again plus. So with this, if we apply the formula of V outside, fine, V outside, then we will say it is equal to KQ over R. And accordingly, Q is given in terms of surface charge density, Fine, and area, that value you can put, and accordingly you can find the correct answer of this question is going to be this one, answer number 1. So we put this question, I mean we classify with very humble approach that this question was also from moderate to slightly difficult. Why I am saying moderate? Reason being, these type of diagrams, when you usually started your studies of class 12th, initial days, you devote a lot of time in general. Fine. So that way, this is not difficult. Yes, recalling the formula, putting the values was up to some extent slightly difficult, not very difficult. So that's why I would like to say, I hope this question you say yes, between the moderate to slightly difficult level. Fine. Then comes this question number 67. Over here, beautiful question based upon the concept of FBD. I'm sure all students preparing for these type of exams like JEE Mains, JEE Advanced, initially in class 11th, they used to devote good amount of time for preparing FBD. Over here, block on block system. So in this question, what I would like to say from my side, this question is from moderate to slightly difficult. Reason being, this situation normally you people study as a separate situation when block on block system, and then this situation. So you can say they combined two concepts together, although they are from the same phenomena. So as such, I think I should not waste your time just by providing a lot of steps in this particular question, but I would like to simply show you the forces over here. That is, I think, important. Fine. So quickly, what I'll do, I'll cut this portion over here, I'll cut this portion over here, and hope you will try to understand. So this is your pulley, and then this is your hanging mass. Fine. It is of given M1, and it is given as M2, and it is M. This block placed on this M2 block, and then this is something which is connected with the pulley. Fine. So if you just simply try to show the forces, then, and yes, of course, some sort of frictional force is also acting in this direction, and then tension T, because as such no friction and nothing is present over here. So accordingly, you can show that these type of forces are acting, and you have to just arrange the forces and solve the particular segment. So it's going to be your answer in the form of 23.3 kg. Fine. So this question was also a basic question based upon the concept of free body diagram and frictional forces. Now this question, few of experts, I mean those my seniors and all, they are saying it is from the thermodynamics, but I think it's a part of the concept of you can say conservation of energy. Fine. So somewhere this solution of this question is going to be very simple, where let me allow to mention, this is something which you learn during the discussion of I would like to mention van der Waal forces in thermodynamics. Fine, these type of results you learn. So let's try to find out the solution of this particular problem, that is F is equal to minus delta U by delta R is equal to K upon R cube. So put the values, simply differentiate it accordingly, you will get the answer of this particular question. Now there is a catch in this problem. What exactly the catch? The catch is, there are two approaches for this particular problem. One approach is the formula I mentioned, do that, read, put the values, solve it. But if you are a clever student, fine, then from this only you can simply say its total energy is zero. Fine. Motion is circular, so net displacement. So that concept is also applicable, but if you want to be double sure, you can use this formula and put the values accordingly. So this question, I would like to say, it comes in the category of moderate. Fine. Not easy one, not difficult as such. Fine. Then comes students your this 69 question. Question is very simple, where if you just read this question, a parallel plate capacitor having some value of capacitance, it is connected to the battery, the value of voltage is given. Fine. Now dielectric material with some constant is inserted between the plates, the magnitude of induced charges. During the discussion, I mean when you started this chapter, when you started your studies in class 12th, these type of questions normally you practice. Fine. So these questions are directly picked from the concepts that you already discussed in your NCERT test books. Fine. So as such, this question was not a very innovative, not a very difficult one. Fine. But a basic question where the formula applicable is K is equal to KCV type of results. And accordingly, we put the values over here and then 1.2 nanocoulomb is the charge. Fine. I am deliberately not explaining the steps required, because as such no innovative steps is required in this particular question. That's why I am simply mentioning the formula. Yes, in JEE advanced type of exams, if these type of questions are asked, then definitely you will find a twist in these type of questions. So if you are well prepared for these type of questions, be sure in your advanced exams you are also going to perform well. And one thing that I would like to repeatedly saying over here, that please don't lose your heart even if you are not in a process like you scored very well in this exam. Fine. It's not like that. If you cleared, I mean, if you get the eligibility to appear in advanced exam, still it's more than 1 month. You can prepare yourself and then you should try to perform well in your advanced exam. So, some sort of required in your preparation, just incorporate those changes and be happy for that. Okay. So, with this positive aspect, let's move ahead. Here, this question is based upon oscillations, or you can say simple harmonic motion. Fine. The approach of this question is slightly different, reason being the language and the silver atoms and the mole weight of the silver, these type of things when incorporated. So let's I will try to mention few steps required over here, although it is not going to be a very difficult question. Fine. So the formula for the time period, obviously T is equal to 2 pi under root m upon k type of result we will use over here. Yes. And then frequency is equal to f is equal to 1 upon t. So put the values over here, you will get f is equal to 1 upon 2 pi under root k by m. And then values are given. Very well, values are given, that is m is equal to mass of one atom. So m is going to be equal to how much? That is going to be, if I am reading these values correctly, 108, which is given over here upon Avogadro's number, that is 6.02 × 10³ over here, and then multiply it by this value of 1 × 10⁻³ kilogram. You will get the correct answer of this particular question, which is going to be 7.1 N·m. Basically, you have to calculate the value of K. Fine. So, this question also, we think we should put it in the category of moderate, because concept is simple, formula is simple. Only twist is in this process of finding the mass m. Because molecular weight is given, Avogadro number is given, and I know you all are very much comfortable in your chemistry subject. So, I hope this is not going to be a difficult aspect for you to calculate the value of mass. Fine. So, that's why I'm saying this question should come in the category of moderate. Okay. Now, it is found that if a neutron suffers an elastic collinear collision with the deuterium at rest, fractional loss of its energy is PD. While for its similar collision with carbon nucleus as rest, fractional loss of energy is PC. The values of PD and PC are respectively. Now, although these terms, neutrons and carbon nucleus and all this, they may create some sort of effect in your mind whether this is from modern physics or so. But if you just try to understand the basic concept they're trying to utilize is linear momentum, energy conservation type of basic concepts that you learn in your basic mechanics. Fine. So let's try to mention this particular formula over here, well-known formula, that is m1 v1 plus m2 v2 is equal to m1 u1 plus m2 u2, the basic result. And accordingly, the kinetic energy relation, half m1 v1 square plus half m2 v2 square plus half m1 u1 square, and so on so forth. Accordingly, you can find the result of this problem. Fine. So that is going to be 0.28, 0.89, as we mentioned in the discussion of the seats, that is correct answers and keys. Now, why I am not solving this particular question in totality? Because also we have some limited time. We have to provide the solution of chemistry and mathematics also. And all those questions which we are finding, that they are simple questions where just a simple guidance of the applied concept or formula will be provided to you. You will find yourself in a comfortable position. Moreover, all these detailed solutions are very soon going to be available at our website. Fine, almost in the process of uploading, so you can check from there also. Fine. Now then comes this question, very beautiful question, but I would like to put this question in the category of simple, easy question, reasoning. Just I will devote some time over here because I'm saying it is easy. The dipole moment of a circular loop, try to recall the magnetic field associated with the circular loop. And then dipole moment. Dipole moment is M is equal to NIA type of formula. N is number of turns. Okay. Is M, and magnetic field at the center of the loop is B1. The formula is mu 0 upon 2 NI R square upon R square plus X square whole to the power 3 by 2. When the dipole moment is doubled by keeping the current constant, the magnetic field at the center of loop is B2. Obviously, if you are maintaining the current but enhancing the dipole moment, so something will happen with the this you can say dipole moment, this magnetic field also. So you have to find the ratio of that magnetic field. One is initial, another is final one. Because formula is simple, that is used. Concept is also very simple. In this question, I'm sure if a student is facing some difficulty, it is because of the reason that that formula is slightly long and how to solve it. In calculation, few of you may make some you can say mistake over here. So, but the question was in a very simple approach. So I would like to simply mention few formulae over here, that is B1 is equal to mu naught I upon 2 R, and one is your R becomes, yes, we solved that. So R becomes root 2 R. Fine. And keeping current constant, so second time M2 you can mention as I into pi, then I into pi upon root 2 R whole square. Fine. So put the values and you solve it accordingly. B1 and B2 is going to be this much, 1 upon root 2. Fine. So that if you will solve it, is 2 is going to be your answer, correct answer. If I said this question, I would like to put in the category of easy question, and few of you, if not ready to accept that, then the only thing I can say, yes, then you can say it is in the category of moderate. But anyway, this question was not difficult because these formulae normally we used to learn while we start a discussion of I think chapter 5 of your class 12 NCERT book. Fine. So that way, direct formula, direct application of that formula, that's why I said it is an easy question. Fine. Then comes this question. It is directly based upon a device, potentiometer. Another question is also asked on this device. Students, these questions, I would like to say surely they comes in the category of easy question, because meter bridge, potentiometer, all these devices, you performed experiment also, you study them also properly. So as such, in these type of questions, nothing is very difficult. Fine, direct questions based upon the concept diagram. So this 1.5 amp, this ohm is the resistance, internal resistance, and the formula used is very simple, that is ES minus ES upon R plus R into small r. Fine. So that formula, that experiment, surely I would like to put this question in the category of easy, because a direct question from directly your textbook. That means it's not like that it is given over there, but the concept and the values, they are definitely put this question in the category of easy one. Fine. One more question is there, I hope. Then this question from the communication part, class 12. One more thing that I would like to share with all of you, a type of, you can say, mismatch in the number of questions. Actually, I explained to that around 16 questions from class 12th and around 14 questions from class 11th. So roughly it is more or less 50% type of balancing approach. But few on few websites or somewhere else, you may find it like 15-15 or something like that. Fine. I think it is just on the basis of the classification. Otherwise, in general, you can say the paper was balanced, equally distributed from class 11th and class 12th. Fine. So it's not like that we represented something wrong or others are representing something wrong. It's anyway not like that. Now, this question, which is directly from the topic of your this communication, fine. Now, in this question, since the carrier frequency is distributed with a band, fine, it is mentioned over here, bandwidth is 5 kilohertz, that is 5 into 10 to the power 10 hertz. So, over here, 10% of 10 gigahertz, 10%, sorry, of 10 gigahertz, fine, is equal to be n into 5 kilohertz. Basic formula applied over here, directly you will get the value of n as 2 into 10 to the power 5 telephone lines. Here I would like to mention one thing. Recently we uploaded a new video in which I explained this communication system. Fine, the entire chapter. There we devoted good amount of time and these type of questions. So if you watch that video, you will find that the same type of concept, almost same type of concept I explained over there. I devoted good amount of time and with the practical example of car, colony and number of users. So that question is directly, if you are regularly watching our videos, definitely you will notice that particular aspect. There I devoted around 10 to 15 minutes time. Fine. So with this, I hope there was some small technical issue. So now it has been resolved. So this question, what I was saying that in our video lectures, we devoted good amount of time on all these aspects, just keeping these questions in mind. So if you just study that particular video, I mean, if you just watch that particular video, you will find that these type of concepts are very properly explained over there. Fine. Here it comes, this question, oh my god, simple question based upon the concept of I is equal to I naught cos square theta, means from one polarizer, another polarizer and so on so forth. So what I'll say this question must be, I mean, if you are not ready to accept that, then I would like to say, okay, let's say it is in moderate level. Otherwise, I should say it's a very simple question, easy one. Which, I mean, any student who just studied the topic, just devoted 10-15 minutes time on this topic of polarization and aspect of the polarizer and analyzer, he or she very easily attempt this question. Fine. So, in this particular question, the concept used is that same formula of I is equal to I naught cos square theta type of result. So, directly you will get after solving cos theta is equal to 1 upon root 2, and that way it is going to be theta is equal to 45 degrees. Fine. So this question, surely, I mean, you also would like to say, sir, this was a very simple question. Fine. Anything innovative, any complicated aspect, nothing is as such applied over here. Fine. Then comes this question on interchanging the resistance of the balance point of the meter bridge. Just try to recall few minutes back I mentioned when there was a question associated with potentiometer. So that's at that point of time I mentioned that one more question directly from these devices. So this is for the meter bridge. Again, I would like to say it's a question which you can classify it as an easy question. Reason being, you performed it, this experiment in your class 12th. Also, you know the formula. You have to just put up the values in this particular question. So, if you solve this question using the result, the final result I would like to mention, that is 1000 minus R1. Fine. That is 110 minus L is equal to R L minus 10. Fine. So this way, if you solve it, you will get the result as R1, then L minus 10 is equal to 100 minus R1 within bracket 110 minus L. Fine. So after solving, this is equation number 1, this is equation number 2. Just use equation 1 and 2. Let's say equation 1 divided by equation 2. After solving this, you will get the value of R1 is equal to 550 ohm. So anyway, few of you may like to say, sir, slight confusion in preparing these equations. No, not at all. During the performance of this experiment in your school laboratory, I'm sure you must have the evaluation and know how to use this formula. Fine. So this question was also, I would like say, in the category of simple. Then well-known question, and definitely what I would like to say that at least all of you must be very happy just by watching this question. Fine, because in general your teacher starts the discussion of center of mass of various type of objects, this type of questions. At least I was not expecting this type of question to be asked in JEE mains exam. Very simple concept. You have a solid disk, cut out some portion, you have to find the moment of inertia of the remaining disk. So what will simply happen at that point of time, I'm sure in class 11th you studied that it is going to shift over here. So once you solve the moment of inertia in both the situations, fine, and equate a simple question, you will get 4mr² is the final answer of this question. This question definitely, I will say, comes in the category of easy. Reason being, if you are preparing for JEE mains advanced type of exams, these questions, I mean, this in this particular class of questions, they used a very simple approach where they just asked a basic concept of this particular question. Fine, just concept of the conservation of this result of moment of inertia. Now, in a collinear collision, a particle with an initial speed V naught strikes a stationary particle of the same mass. What is the category of this question? Conservation of linear momentum. Fine, of linear momentum. So this question again from your class 11th topics. Fine, and once apply the formulae of initial momentum and final momentum. I am not writing down the equation directly because I mentioned that equation just 3-4 questions back. M1, V1, M2, V2. So directly I would like to mention the result as V1 minus V2 is equal to root 2 V0. Now, few of you may say, because of the calculation involved over here, we would like to put in a moderate level question. Fine. If you wish so, you can put. But if you are a hardworking student and you prepared all these concepts very well, then obviously you will find this question in the simple category. Fine. Then comes, students, this question directly from EM waves. The results are given E value, that is electric field, and these two values for electric fields are given in air and in medium. K is wave number, nu is frequency. Fine. So this question is basically directly from your this topic of EM waves, class 12 topic, and as such the final result that you are supposed to use is as C is equal to 1 upon mu naught epsilon naught in air or in vacuum, and velocity V is equal to 1 upon mu epsilon, that is applicable for any medium. So accordingly, if you compare these two results, you will get the value of ER1 fine upon ER2 as 1 by 4. So in class 12, at least this chapter is such a simple and small chapter that normally all students love to devote good amount of time over here. Now, these type of questions we discussed, we elaborated in our video lectures, specifically because I prepared those video lectures for this topic, that is electromagnetic waves. My simple request to all of you, just take a look of those videos. You will find your concepts more clear in this particular category. Fine. RLC circuit, direct formula based question, quality factor Q is given by. This is nothing but a result. The answer is clear to all of you. So I would like to move on to the next question. Fine. Direct formula based question. What I'll say about this question, that is, specifically I'm saying, everyone will appreciate this fact. Very simple, direct formula they asked. Direct formula. Fine. No calculation, nothing is required. I don't know what exactly the logic behind this question, but they are examination bodies. And yes, the most beautiful aspect of this question, class 11th, initial days, various type of graphs. Fine. Now, these graphs intended to present the same motion. One of them does it incorrectly. You have to pick that particular question. Now, this question comes in the category to check whether you are in a process of recalling your basics that you learned in class 11th not properly or not. Fine. So in that way, you can say in this particular situation, 1 is the correct answer. Reason being, 2 and 4 are corresponding to the positions. Fine. And then 3, it is distance time graph. So this 1 is the graph which is representing distance with time is something which is not properly representing the situation, incorrect representation. This question is again, I would like to say, put in the category of easy question. Then simple circuit, fine. And from calculation point of view, I would like to say that this question is a question which you can say a difficult one. I mean, gradually moving from moderate to difficult level. Fine. Why? Because I would like to mention the entire circuit over here. I would like to devote some amount of time for this particular question. Please, hope you will try to understand. Everyone, just take a look of this question. It is 12 volt. It is 1 ohm. Then it is 13 volt. Fine. 1 3 volt. And 1 is, this is 2 ohm, and then it is given as 10 ohm resistor. Fine. This is the diagram. So first, why I'm saying it is difficult one, because initially you have to visualize this diagram. That is one aspect which definitely needs some amount of time and thinking. So one aspect is, you can say this question comes in a slightly difficult level. After that, once you resolve it, final answer, then after resolving this particular problem, finally you will get the potential across 10 ohm this resistance is equal to I into 10. That will give you 37 by 32 into 10. Fine. So finally you will get 11.56 as the correct answer. So that way you can say it is going to be the correct solution of this particular question is going to be 1. Okay, that is 11.56, so 11.5 to 11.6 is the correct answer. So this visualization of the circuit was slightly difficult. That's why I'm saying this question should come in the category of difficult, moderate to difficult reason. Now, a particle is moving with a uniform speed in a circular orbit of radius r in a central force inversely proportional to the nth power of r. Few students definitely would like to solve this question on the basis of the concepts they learned in your gravitational chapter. Fine. That is, T square is directly proportional to r cube of type of result. So, let me allow to mention this quick question over here. That is, basic formula used as mv square upon r is equal to force which is directly proportional to 1 upon r square, because it is given as a central force. Fine. So, omega is directly proportional to 1 upon r, that is n plus 1 by 2. Fine. So, now from here you can easily find out that the answer of this question is going to be directly proportional to n plus 1 by 2. I directly mentioned the omega because m omega square r, I put it like this, or mv square upon r, ultimately this circular motion is given, that's why I use this particular formula. So, that way this question, obviously don't say it is in the easy category. Yes, let's devote the category of this question as moderate question. Fine, concept is very simple. Then this question definitely I will say in the category of easy question. Reason being, what is the formula for the wave number? That is 1 upon lambda is equal to r, and then 1 upon n1 square minus 1 upon n2 square. Fine. So, you will get this result. Just put the value, solve it accordingly. You will get the Phoon series and Lyman series results. Now, this question for all those students who love to prepare certain results is going to be very useful. Reason being, they can solve directly this question in just one step if they are in a process to remember these values. Otherwise, it consumes good amount of time in calculation because this formula is slightly long one. Otherwise, this question was not a very difficult one, and this VL upon 25 is the correct answer. Fine. During the discussion of atomic physics Bohr's model, normally teachers suggest you to remember few values on the basis of this direct result. That's why it is also very important to remember these results. Reason being, solving these long results in examination hall definitely creates a problem for the time management. Fine. Then this question, based upon your simple electromagnetic induction and AC current. So, I would like to say from the calculation point of view, this question comes in the category of moderate. Not easy, because question is this calculation is slightly difficult, and this category is not very difficult. So, you cannot say it's a difficult one. No, not at all. So, this question, the solution should be in a simple fashion, will be given like this. P average, let me allow to mention, P average is equal to VRMS into IRMS cos of theta. Fine. So, once you solve it, you will get the value as 10 amperes for wattless current. So, that's why I am saying direct formula based question, not as such very difficult one. So, you can say it's in the category of moderate. Now, this question is from the kinetic theory of gases. 2 moles of an ideal monatomic gas occupies a volume this much. Gas expands adiabatically to a volume this much. Calculate the final temperature and change in the internal energy. General basic questions which normally students love to study during their class 11. So, as such, combination of two simple questions, and then they created one big question with two options in each, I mean the options provided, A, B in 1, 2, 3, 4. So, from the calculation point of view, I will say, yes, this question comes in the category of moderate to difficult. Then V gamma minus 1 is directly proportional to 1 upon T, direct formula. And also you can say finally T2 is equal to T1, because I am directly writing these steps, that's why I am just taking this help of my solutions. Fine. Otherwise, detailed solutions are almost in a process of uploading. So you can get the results from there. This formula is simply used over here, and accordingly you can find the results of this particular question. That is like -2.7 kilojoule and 189 Kelvin. So this answer is going to be 2 is the correct answer, with A 189, B -2.7 kilojoule. Fine. Yes, moderate, because some amount of calculation is required. Now, a solid sphere of radius r made up of a soft material. Try to recall, just some time back when I was mentioning the topics from where the question has been picked in this paper, I specifically mentioned it is from the fluid dynamics, fluid statics, fluid dynamics, class 11th question. Fine. So in this question, you have to find the value of bulk modulus. I'm directly writing V is equal to delta V upon, let me allow to mention that formula in terms of volume stress upon volumetric strain. Fine. Volumetric strain. And then you can put the values as K is equal to, given in the question, mg over A dV by V. Fine. And accordingly, fractional change in volume, dV upon V is equal to 3 dr upon r. Then using the result dr upon r, you will get the formula as mg upon 3 kA. So that is 2 is the correct answer. So because some amount of calculations, arrangement of the certain terms is associated over here, so obviously you can say that this question comes in the category of slightly difficult category, or slightly more than the moderate category. Fine. Then a granite rod. Now this granite rod is nothing but, just to confuse you, claimed at its middle point and is set into longitudinal vibrations. The density of granite is this much, Young's modulus is this much. What will be the fundamental? So students, again we are back with some sort of technical issues. Okay, so in this question, basically we are supposed to explain that velocity is equal to Young's modulus upon density, and also lambda is equal to 2L. Basically what we are trying to find out, we are trying to find out F is equal to V over lambda. Why? Because in the question it is given that rod is clamped in the mid portion. So it is going to be like this way the formation. Fine. Rough diagram I am just trying to give you, so please don't mind it. And accordingly, once you calculate, you will get this answer as 5 kilohertz. So the diagram is with you, the basic formula is with you. If you wish, you can put this question in the category of moderate one. Fine. But I think this is a very simple question based from this concept of longitudinal vibrations. Although they tried to twist the question slightly, that's why I'm putting this in a moderate category. Now, mass of hydrogen molecule, if this much, and if if 10 to the power 23 hydrogen molecules strike per second, a fixed wall of area this much at an angle of 45 degree to the normal, and rebound elastically with the speed 10 to the power 3 meter per second, find the pressure on the walls nearby. Students, basic formula, force is force, area and pressure relation, you know that. So this question I would like to put directly in the form of P is equal to F upon A. I am not going into the details of putting the values directly. I am writing the result because this formula is very simple one. That is 2mnv cos of 45 degrees upon 2 into 10 to the power minus 4. Directly you will solve, you will get 2.35 into 10 to the power 3 newton per meter square is the pressure. Directly formula based question. If you are in a process to say, sir, I'm not comfortable with the calculation, then you can say it's a moderate question. Otherwise, this formula you learn during the discussion of KTG, kinetic theory of gases, in the same fashion. Slight twisting, nothing else. So finally, here comes the most beautiful question of this paper, I would like to say. Not a difficult one, simple question. Fine. What the formula you have to use over here? I'm sure this question till now you must have read around 10-20 times. So directly I'm writing the formula. I net is equal to I naught plus mx square type of concept. I'm just putting the values over here in this format, that I net is equal to I naught, that is ICM, plus 6m into 4r square. Fine. Put the values in this manner, that is 7/2 mr square. I also provide you the diagram, just wait for a few seconds, and then plus this term, it will give you 55/2 mr square. And finally, when you add this value 7/2 mr square over here, final result you will get it as 181/2 mr square. Let me give you quickly, just in few seconds, the diagram of this particular situation. This is one, and this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Quickly just take a look, one, just rough diagram I'm trying to show you, so please don't mind it. Now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and this one is in the middle. So ultimately you just add up all these, fine, and then you have to calculate. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then this 7 1, that's why 7/2 I mentioned. So this way, very quickly, in a very short fashion, students, we tried our best to provide you the correct solution of these answers, a first hand glimpse, you can say, of these questions. Obviously detailed solution very shortly is going to be with you. So now I would like to say thanks to all of you. Please be ready for the coming session of another subject. Thanks a lot.